Next up on member profiles, we have a brand new member of the Anoka Area Chamber of Commerce. The name of the business is Elite Sound. His name is Julio Alarcon. How'd I do?
You did great.
Okay.
Great, Pete.
Got a feeling I didn't, but it was close enough. All right. I had a chance to meet Julio at the Champlin business event that they held earlier this summer out at the Mississippi Crossing Event Center. You and I had a chance to chat.
Yep.
We talked about how the chamber might be able to help you. And one of those ways, here you are, Julio. I told you about the show, and here you are.
Here I am. Yes, sir.
All right. So Elite Sound, first off, what is it?
We are a DJ company, entertainment company.
And when you say DJ, so if somebody's getting married, you guys could be in play.
Yep. We handle pretty much any event that any music is needed,
right,
from, you know, weddings, corporate parties, corporate events, holiday parties, birthday parties, school events, prom, Sadie Hawkins, your homecomings. We can accommodate anything and all of it.
So Julio, how'd you get started in this?
Well, funny story, my father-in-law is a DJ.
Oh, is that right? Did not know that.
In Florida. He lives in Florida.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we would go visit him, you know, at least, you know, once a year.
Sure.
And I will, you know, see all his equipment and everything involved into what he was doing. And a few times I went with him to some of his events, and I saw him, you know, DJ the event and all everything, logistics and everything that goes along with that. And, you know, I started asking questions.
Sure.
Like, you know, what do you like about it? Is it difficult? Is it not difficult? Like, how did you manage to get everybody on the dance floor and just, you know, trying to learn more about it. You know, something in the back of my mind. And then in 2016, an acquaintance of mine was able to get me in to a local DJ company down in Savage. And that's pretty much how I got started.
I will tell you this. You know, every time I've seen a DJ in play, they're always having a good time.
Oh, yeah.
You know, I mean, they always have a smile on their face, and they can really pick an event up, and we'll talk about that in a little bit. What keeps you motivated at Elite Sound?
The fact that I could become self-employed and be able to manage mm-hmm. my own time, my own pay, my own clients, and anything that goes wrong is on me, not on anyone else.
Good point. You know, and one of the things that comes with that is it's challenging. You know, everybody doesn't open up their own business. There's a reason, because it's not easy. It is hard. You know, and I always congratulate people, because it's like, you know what? You picked up the dice, you blew on them and said, yeah, I'll open up a business. Well, let me tell you something. It is not as easy as it sounds. What are some of the challenges that you have seen with you owning your own business?
I believe like some of the challenges is obviously clients trying to get them to trust you, and what you're trying to sell is what they're expecting,
right,
and that you go above and beyond.
Right.
I mean, obviously, I wish somebody would tell me all the office related job that, you know, accounting and paperwork and, you know, bookkeeping and, you know, calendars and appointments, and it's a lot.
It is.
It's a lot.
People don't understand, man. A to Z is long, and that, when you're the boss, especially in a smaller business, you're everything. So you are going to handle all of it and try to make a go of it and still pump out the product and do it in a good, solid, and professional way. And it takes a lot of work. And again, hats off to you. What are some of the challenges to see DJing?
DJing, you know, it's a craft.
Yeah.
Like any other type of service that you need to practice to get better.
Mm-hmm.
You need to be able to get familiarized with not only the current music that it's out there, but, you know, you deal with several other types of people in these events, several other types of generations
yeah.
that perhaps are not they don't listen to what's out there in the radio right now.
Right.
And so you need to be able to cater to those people and be able to, you know, get them out on the floor and make sure that they are also having fun. It's not just about, you know, the, you know, 20, 30-year-olds. We also need to look after the, you know, 50, 60, 70-year-olds that they like music, just like all of us do.
Hello, you're darn right you do, and I'm one of those 60s, and give me a little Diana Ross, give me some Temptations, maybe a little Elvis, and I'll be happy. You know, and you're right, man, this is about working with these people to make sure that they understand that, look, yes, as an example, a wedding, yes, this is your event, but, you know, let us at Elite Sound help you kind of figure out all of it. Sure, you want some stuff and some specialty stuff for like that father-daughter dance, those types of things. But you do have a large contingency of people, and here's some of our thoughts about the best way to make your event the best that it can be. And that's where Elite Sound can take your event from here and pop it up to there, and that's where Julio can make that difference. And I'm sure you've worked with a lot of clients. What do they love about you and your business?
They really like how flexible I am. Like, I can pretty much accommodate any request within reason that they desire and they think of. I really try to separate my company from all the big ones out there. I'm not a huge fan of nickel and dime people. And so some of the things that other companies do charge that I do not charge are, for example, mileage. Mm-hmm. I don't charge for mileage. I can go pretty much anywhere that I can get through with a car, regardless of distance, at no cost to the client.
Sure.
I don't charge for any lodging, whereas other companies, they require for the client to pay for the lodging of the DJ or photographer or whoever, especially if the event is within, you know, a few hours from their home base.
Yep.
I don't charge for that. I don't charge for any teardown at the end of the night or any setup at the beginning of the day. So those little things.
They add up, man.
You know, it does add up. And like some of these clients that are already paying, you know, thousands of dollars to make their day special, you know, with venue and caterers and other type of vendors, that I feel that I don't need to add more to that.
Yeah, that's great. You had talked about ways that you have worked to make yourself better, to understand the music more and make Elite Sound the best that it can be. Is DJing something that's hard to get into?
No, it's not. If you are willing to put in the work necessary to get better. You can have, you know, all the knowledge in the world about music, but if you're not familiarized yourself with the equipment, for one, understand the highs and lows of the music, you know, have that type of ear that for everybody else sounds great, but you know that something is off and it's not sounding right. And even if you don't know all about music, you know, it's always good to listen to other genres. Mm-hmm. You know, broad yourself with, you know, perhaps you were not a country person, but now that you're a DJ, there are country people out there. You need to start listening to some country in order for you to cater to that type of clients.
Because at Elite Sound, it's all about the client.
Correct. It's all about the client. It's all about their desire, their expectations, you know. We work for you. You don't work for us.
I mean, the goal is simple. You want their event to be elite.
Correct.
And Elite Sound can help them get there.
Yep. We sure can.
All right. Julio, somebody out there is interested. Somebody's got a daughter that they're getting ready to get married. They're looking for a DJ. Or maybe we've got one of our chamber members with a corporate event coming up, and they want to have that type of a scenario that really takes that event three steps up, and Elite Sound can do it. How would somebody get a hold of you and start the process of having a conversation?
So I do have a website. That's www.elite-sound.com. I do have a Facebook page. Also, you can easily find me if you just search Elite Sound on Facebook. I'm one of the top the top results.
Yep.
In there, you can reach me that way as well. And then, you know, with through the Chamber of Commerce, I am also listed as well. You can talk to Pete.
Yep.
And then he'll be able to direct you my way as well.
Yeah, you can go to the Chamber website, and they will be listed up on our website. We always urge people to use Chamber members. And if you are looking for someone that can put sound into your event and take it over the top, Elite Sound is the way to do it. Julio, lastly, do you have anything else that you want to talk about from the standpoint, do you do anything else besides DJing, or is that it?
No, we actually just started this year hosting trivia nights at several locations around the metro. Currently, we do trivia at Maple Tavern on Maple Grove on Monday nights at 6:30. And as of Tuesday, 2 days ago, we were able to land Broadway Pizza in Rogers.
Excellent.
And they're going to start next week Tuesday, in every Tuesday night at 7 p.m. Over in those two places. So, yeah, come on down if you are a trivia fanatic and you think you know everything. Let's see if you know everything.
And they can find out more information about those events on your website as well?
No, so okay. the trivia, it's not listed on my website. I do have a separate Facebook page exclusive for trivia. If you just search DJ Trivia Hennepin West, then you'll be able to find all the locations, the times, and then everything and all information regarding those two locations.
Great. He's Julio. He is with Elite Sound. You want your event to take three steps up, Elite Sound can help make it happen. All right, we're taking a break. When we come back, we are going to wrap up this edition of the Chamber Report.